city. That's me right now in my kitchen. We're in the beginning stages of soft pretzel dough. I'll link the recipe I kind of follow down below, but we've got a cup and a half of warm water. I aim for a temperature of 105 or 110 degrees Fahrenheit. And to that, I've added some yeast. I normally use what's in that jar, but this one I've had in my fridge for a while, so I figured I would use a new packet and just add the rest that I needed from ye old yeast jar. We want to give it something to munch on, so we're adding 2 tablespoons of honey. In the realm of food, I would say yeast and mushrooms impress me the most. I just feel like they wield so much power. They come across as very alpha and complex. I used to be intimidated by recipes involving yeast. You know, that was a hard pass for me, but now anything bread related is just my favorite, and that all really started when I made soft pretzels for the first time. Now we're going to let our little yeast cocktail sit. Smell so much because it's something that you typically only experience when you or someone is making homemade bread, to generalize. But then there's this accompanying excitement of something good is gonna come out of the oven today. You saw me and see me lightly filling my cup with flour because you're technically not supposed to pack flour. So, because I'm on camera, I thought I'd try to be slightly more proper, but whatever. Because I've made this recipe so many times now, I know that even when I pack the flour just by the act of scooping it in a cup, I always end up having to incorporate a lot during the kneading process, regardless. Recommend erring on the side of conservative flour usage when you're trying a recipe for the first time. You can always add more, and bread with too much flour is not a fun time. I added salt to the flour as well, but apparently I wasn't filming. Normally when I make these, I add fresh rosemary during this step, but I don't have any, and I am not venturing out to get any. The original recipe calls for thyme, but I like rosemary more, so just have fun with your herbs, people. We are finally going to mix everything together. It will be shaggy and fairly dry at first, but I think because of that honey and that melted butter, it will quickly become sticky and stay very well saturated for a while, which is why I have to continually add flour during the kneading process. I want to mention that even though I used 2 cups bread flour and 2 cups all-purpose, I've made this before using just all-purpose plenty of times, and though it's a bit fluffier and softer in texture with the bread flour, all-purpose is alright, so don't fret. This recipe is very versatile, and like I said, it's fun to play around with herbs. You can play around with the cheese you want to stuff inside. That's the fun part. We'll get there. You could add pancetta, which is what the original recipe calls for, though I've never added meat to my pretzels. I've done these with roasted garlic inside, which is good. Though I'm also someone that could just eat roasted garlic straight up, so whatever it's added to, I'm a fan of. We are going to because it's the end of the book, and the teacher got so mad at me, and she was like, "You spoiled this book for everyone." I was like, did not know this second grade classroom was a spoiler-free zone. Again, we're going to tuck in our cheese. You're going to want to stuff them pretty well, as once they up, there will be a lot of bread to contend with. I knew I wasn't going to have enough cheese for all of them, so I made the executive decision to stuff 6 normally, as opposed to skimping out a bit to get all of them filled. This was weird because I don't know if I've ever rolled them up without cheese or something inside, so I wasn't really sure. It just felt very foreign to me. I was not used to that consistency. But as I've been rolling up my pretzels and placing them on parchment paper, I've let a pot of water boil, to which we're going to add a 3/4 cup of baking soda. We're going to let our pretzels soak for like a minute. I don't know, I never time it before sticking them in the oven. Once they've soaked, we're going to brush on an egg wash so we can top them with coarse sea salt. I was a head ass and forgot to preheat the oven because I was so focused on the filming aspect of the situation actually, so the pretzels had to sit after soaking for a little while. Not sure what that sort of neglect does to a pretzel, but I think they turned out all right. I just watched, well, a while ago, an episode of Good Mythical Morning. Shout out to my fellow mythical beasts. But Rhett and Link ate cooked foods that are normally raw, and raw foods that are normally cooked. So at one point they ate a Philly cheesesteak that was raw beef sandwiched in bread dough, topped with cheese slices or cheese shreds, I don't know. But it was horrid, and it made me imagine taking a bite out of one of these before baking them, which also horrid. So because I had those two pretzels with no cheese filling, I decided to top them with cinnamon sugar, which you'll see just for fun. And it was all right. Like, I guess I would do it again. It didn't taste super cohesive, so I'd just have to play around with the recipe a bit, but yeah, it wasn't bad. I did save the cinnamon sugar in a little bowl because I obviously wasn't going to throw any extra away, but later that night I accidentally dumped the entire bowl over the counter, so I don't like for my pretzels to be super salty, so I didn't add that much, but to be honest, should have added more. I never add the correct amount. It's either way too much and I'm like crying and shredding the roof of my mouth with salt granules, or it's non-existent. It's like the water temperature in my basement shower. There's no in between. I also should have definitely added more cinnamon sugar. Don't come at me. The oven works in mysterious ways, and I just could have used more somehow. I usually bake these around 18 minutes. That typically works well, but definitely keep an eye on them. The cinnamon sugar girls were definitely bleak in appearance compared to their sisters, but I'd say this was a good batch. The mozzarella